The issue of eviction of herdsmen in some states is generating a lot of issues across the country, just as Kano State Governor Abdullahi Ganjude suggested that the National Assembly should pass a law to stop movement of cattle. Some are saying such law would contravene the constitution. Now joining me via Skype is Jibrin Okutupe, a senior advocate of Nigeria, to shed more light on this issue. Thank you very much, Jibrin, for joining us on News Now. Now, is there a legal way to resolve this tension of eviction of herdsmen sweeping across the country?
Well, I think the issue of legal ways of resolving, or the issue of herdsmen, as you call them, has been politicized. But let me first of all say that under the Nigeria Constitution, every Nigerian of every ethnic nationality has the right to move and reside in any part of the country. But having said that, the same constitution also vests in the state to issue orders, to issue directives, and to promulgate law that are reasonable, justifiable in democratic society in the interest of peace, order, and security of Nigeria or of the that part of the state. Now, I have spoken on this issue of quit notice allegedly said to have been issued by the Ondo State government to the herdsmen. And if we carefully read that notice, it is not a notice that you must leave Ondo, but it's a notice that don't move in any particular place at any particular time without first and foremost getting registered, getting permission, and so on and so forth. Now, let me say that herdsmen, apart from those who are engaging in criminality or alleged to be engaging in criminalities, are Nigerians filing their trades in herdsmen, I mean cows and cattle across Nigeria. That to me constitutes business. And no one does business in any part of this country without following the laid down procedures and law of that place. For instance, there is a provision of our law dealing with registration of business name, registration of business premises. And so if there is a directive that before you can move to a forest reserve, you should get registered and get permission, I do not see that as a violation of our constitution. Against the background of the fact that there are a series of allegations, but yet to be proved, that the people responsible for kidnapping, raping, assault, destructions of farmlands, and so on and so forth, are Fulani herdsmen. So, for me, rather than this talking about legal resolution, the will, political will, to resolve this issue and bring to book those among Fulani herdsmen who engage in criminalities and punishing them according to law should be considered seriously by both the federal and state government concerned. After all, the duty of government is to ensure that lives and properties are safe, are preserved, and no one is unnecessarily murdered or killed or deprived of his liberty and his right and his life. So I think that the answer to your question will be more of a political solution rather than legal solution. Because the legal solution I see is to arrest every criminal element that rape, maim, and kill, and bring them before the court of law and charge them according to law. So no one has the liberty to take law into his hand.
I'm sorry to cut you so short at this time, but some have argued that the state governors do not have the power to evict any citizen residing in the state. So is this against the fundamental rights of a citizen? And do you share the same belief?
Abuse of language to talk about eviction. I do not see anyone that has the right to evict any Nigerian from any part of Nigeria, as long as he's a Nigerian citizen. But we must understand the notice within the context of the letters and spirit of the notice. The notice is that, look, don't go to the forest reserve without permission. don't move in the night. Those are reasonably justifiable orders in democratic society. Because even every this freedom we are talking about, there is no freedom without limitation. One of the limitations is that if you engage in criminal conduct, you can be arrested. One of the limitations is also that you can be restricted and your liberty curtailed if the liberties of others are in jeopardy. And we are all aware in this country that the security of Nigerians are in serious jeopardy. You may see somebody who came from America on his way to the airport, he was arrested and, kidnapped and slaughtered and killed. No government should be happy that such things is happening, because there will be no investment, there will be no economic development, everybody will be scared of the area. So rather than politicizing this, or the governor, Ganduje is saying that they should start restricting Fulani herdsmen from moving out of the east or west. The political leadership was very serious and then these serious criminal activities that is permeating every structure of society.
Well, certainly we hope the government looks at this issue. But thank you very much, Senior Advocate of Nigeria, Jibrin Okutepe, for sharing your thoughts on this matter.